Greetings, Sky Watchers, and welcome to the sky above us. I'm James Albury, and I'm your tour guide to the night sky. It's that time of year again when two summertime constellations mark the location of a mysterious interloper at the center of our galaxy. Plus, the moon plays a visit to each of the naked eye planets over the next few weeks. What am I talking about? Let me show you. All the stars we can see in the night sky are part of what we call the Milky Way galaxy. Our galaxy is comprised of over 100 billion stars, and they all orbit around a common center of mass. The shape of our galaxy is what we call a barred spiral, because if we could view our galaxy from above, the gas, dust, and stars fan out into both a spiral shape and what appears to be a bar running through the center of it. We don't have any actual pictures of our galaxy from the outside because our galaxy is so enormous. It's so large that a beam of light takes over 100,000 years to cross from one side of the galaxy to the other. We are about two-thirds of the way out from the center of the galaxy, and it takes our solar system over 250 million years to make one orbit around the galactic center. At the center of our galaxy is a supermassive black hole. A black hole forms when a very large star dies, exploding as a supernova, and its core collapses on itself, producing a gravitational field so great that light can't escape. The least massive black holes start off at about 25 times the mass of the Sun. But the black hole at the center of our galaxy is over 4 million times the mass of the Sun. Therefore, its gravitational influence causes all the stars in our galaxy to orbit it, almost like horses on a merry-go-round. So where in the sky can you find this gravitational powerhouse? Let me show you. Okay, we have our sky set up for 8:30 p.m. on August 26th, facing south. The constellations of Scorpius the Scorpion and Sagittarius the Centaur flank our point of interest. On the night of August 26th, the moon will be very close to the spot we're talking about. Unfortunately, the brightness of the moon makes seeing the Milky Way impossible. But if you view the same area of the sky during the first week of September, and view it from a very dark location, you'll see a cloudy ribbon of light rising upward between Scorpius and Sagittarius. This is the Milky Way galaxy. From where we are, we see the galaxy edge on. The center of the galaxy is about 4.5 degrees west of Al-Nazl, the star marking the tip of the teapot of Sagittarius. There's so much dust in this part of the Milky Way that you can't see the galactic center. But aim a telescope or binoculars in this area and you'll be treated to a display of over 1 million stars. There are so many stars here that it really does look like a cloudy, milky region of space. Alright, let's quickly check out where the moon and planets will be this month. Okay, we again have our sky set up for 8:30 p.m. on August 26th facing south. The waxing gibbous moon will be just to the west of Jupiter and Saturn. Jupiter is the bright star-like object to the right, and Saturn is the one on the left. Let's watch the moon's progression. Here's the view on August 27th, August 28th, and the moon is very close to Jupiter, August 29th, now the moon is close to Saturn, and August 30th. As you see, the moon didn't waste any time zipping past both Jupiter and Saturn. The next pairing is going to be even more impressive. If you remember last month, the Moon and Mars had a close pairing in the sky. Well, we get to see it again, but this time it's even closer. On the night of September 5th, the Moon will be less than its own width away from Mars. But from some parts of the world, like central Brazil, they can actually see an occultation, where the Moon will temporarily eclipse Mars for about an hour. Lastly, we have the Moon and Venus. If we set our clock for 5 a.m. on September 14th, we'll see a beautifully slender waning crescent moon 4 degrees away from dazzling Venus. Both objects will be in Cancer the Crab, which is between Leo the Lion and the Gemini twins. So, my friends, head outside and look for the center of our galaxy, and while you're at it, watch the moon zip past the planets. And if you'd like to support our program, click on the Patreon link in the description, and you could qualify for autographed The Sky Above Us memorabilia, and you could see your name in the credits of our next episode. It's amazing what you can find in the sky, especially when you keep looking up.